Dear participants in Inside the Black Box, I'm Erik Solheim, the chair of the OECD Development Assistance Committee, in short, the international body which sets the rules for what will be considered development assistance. Before that, I was Minister of Environment and International Development in my home country, in Norway. Thank you for participating in Inside the Black Box. I think we need a lot of good ideas for how we can do development assistance better, but please never hesitate. Development assistance, it has been a huge global success story. It has brought hundreds of millions of people out of extreme poverty, and by and large the world is doing very well. I mean, absolute extreme poverty has been reduced by 1% every year since the 1990s. And let me share with you a few of the astonishing success stories. Vietnam, poor Asian nation, is now doing better in education for their 15 years old than most European nations, and indeed I think also better than Holland or Germany. Ethiopia, one of the poorest nations in Africa, has reduced the number of children dying before the age of 5 with 2/3 in 2 decades. An astonishing result no one would have thought possible. They've done it by educating village nurses who take part in childbirth and assist young mothers in raising the children and getting vaccines, etc. Brazil has reduced the deforestation rate in the Amazon with 80%, the greatest contribution to the struggle against climate change of any nation in the world, and fantastic service for biodiversity. And you would also know a huge number of the other success stories. China for sure has reduced poverty enormously. Chile, most Latin American nations. There are so many success stories. This is not just due to development assistance, but also partly due to that. But we're also living in a rapidly evolving world. Development assistance is not just done by Europe or the United States. It's now done by China, by Turkey, by many Latin American nations, by Indonesia, even Mexico. It's a new, much more fascinating and much more promising world. And a lot of private actors are coming in. For sure, private investment is important, but also, say, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, a private institution of rich people in the United States, as you would know, they're providing more development assistance than most nations of the world. So development assistance has been great success story, improved life of children all over the globe fantastically. Think of the fact that India now declared that for the third consecutive year, India is free of polio. When I was a child, I remember some of my friends being disabled for life due to polio here in the midst of Europe. And as late as in the 1980s, hundreds of thousands of children in India were getting polio every year. So again, it's a big success story, but we should also look into how we can spend the money more effectively. Let me mention some ideas to you. For sure, we must assist developing nations in keeping peace. Every civil war in any nation is disabling people, killing people, but it's also putting the nation 20 to 30 years back when it comes to development. So looking into how development assistance can support peace processes and bring people out of wars when they are in the midst of war, like in South Sudan or Central African Republic, is key to development. We should also look into how we can spend money more wisely to provide more and better private investment. For sure, the private sector is everywhere and key to development. No one can think of the extremely rapid reduction in poverty in Korea or in China without the efforts of the private sector investment in every sector. And we should look into, can development money be used as a leveraging instrument for private sector? For instance, we're taking some of the risk when a private company wants to invest in very difficult places, say in Africa. And we should look into how we can ask development nations in a system in spending more money on mobilizing domestic resources. Even in the poorest of nations, normally there are some rich people. They will also, or very often, be a middle class. They can pay taxes, and then provide for education and health and road building vaccines for the poor through domestic resources. Small investment in better tax systems in many nations have provided enormous returns. $1 spent have in some cases given more than $100 return. This is the best investment you can ever do. So let's spend also development money for better tax systems. These are just some of the ideas on health. There have been huge progress in the world in the last few years, thanks to better and more wisely spent development assistance. And on education, we are in a situation where nearly all children in the world are attending the first classes in school, but unfortunately many still do not get the best sort of education and are not learning enough in school, and we should for sure also bring in the rest into school, and we need ideas as to how to do these better. So let me encourage you to take a hard look at development assistance. How can we spend the money better? What are your ideas to move this agenda forward? What would you suggest your Prime Minister or the President of the United States or China to do? And feel certain that whatever ideas you produce, we will definitely look into them. And I'm very, very eager to see what you can produce. This is a chance for you to bring forward ideas which hopefully can be implemented by politicians and civil society organizations. So good luck.